Mars, what an interesting target that is. I am delighted to learn that the United Arab Emirates is sending a HOPE probe to Mars. This is a mission that carries so many dimensions to its value to the United Arab Emirates, to the Arab states, to the world. The mission is going to go into orbit around Mars and measure its atmosphere. That's something that no one has really done before. We've been distracted by its surface, all right? Might there be life? Is there water? Are there polar ice caps? Meanwhile, what does the atmosphere tell us? Any indication of what the atmosphere was once like? What it will be like in the future? Oh my gosh. You don't have water unless there's an atmosphere that can support it. Science is the greatest source of collaborations of nations there ever was. Why? Because scientists speak the same language as each other. Same with engineers and mathematicians. So it is inherently ripe for bringing international collaborators with you so they can participate in your dreams. We did that in the United States, all right? We didn't just create a space program all by ourselves. No, we got help. And you know what that did for us back then? These were headlines. Oh my gosh, I want to be an astronaut. I want to be an engineer. I want to be a scientist. You didn't need special programs to excite people. They just wanted to do it because it was a point of pride. It was a point of participation. Everyone was cheering. And so if you can capture that spirit with your HOPE probe, not only in the United Arab Emirates itself, but in the Arab states, you can ensure generations of people will want to carry that torch forward. And by the way, this torch has kind of always been there. So the legacy is there. And you just have to look back a little ways and say, yeah, that used to happen. And it used to happen here in the Middle East. And looking at how you've conceived the project, oh my gosh, with the fraction of women who are participating in it at all levels of the project, as scientists, engineers, and managers, the fact that women are a big part of that will ensure that your future is reaching for all the best ideas, the best talent that could possibly be produced on that frontier of exploration. So that's what makes it just a spectacular mission. It's an affirmation that exploration and discovery is not really just for scientists, it's for us all. So, congratulations. And I'll even say good luck, because sometimes you need a little bit of that too. Oh, I'll add one more thing. When you're on the frontier, occasionally stuff goes wrong. Nothing wrong with that, all right? Some wise mentors I've had told me, the day you stop making mistakes is the day you can guarantee you are no longer on the frontier.